I think I messed it up. We were gonna do a little like one of these, but I messed it up. Anyway, okay, that's gonna be how today goes. How's everybody doing? It is a kind of dark day. The sun was out about an hour ago, I promise, and then some clouds have rolled in, so it's actually not nighttime here in Texas. It is, it's 2 o'clock, 2 p.m. Central. It's just, it might rain. It's just cloudy because it might rain, but I think we're gonna be okay. Anyway, we are so glad you guys are here. We have an awesome product to show off and talk about and answer all your questions. It's gonna be a ton of fun. So let me just start this off with just a little bit of information. Okay, so we are giving away, our brand new station. So to do that, what are you gonna wanna do before you do anything else? Before you put any other comments or anything, I mean, you can say hi, but tag a friend. We want to get as many people in here so we can talk about the station, because I think it's awesome. A lot of people in the company worked really, really hard to bring you something super cool and something that you're going to be excited, I think, to put in your backyard. So tag a friend, let them know that we're demoing the station today. We're announcing it. It's going to be a ton of fun. Get that in there, and then that's really all we need you to do. And then maybe give us a like and a share and that kind of stuff if you feel like being generous. So I hope everybody is having an awesome Friday. It's almost the weekend. You guys did it. I'm glad that it's Memorial Day weekend, actually. So that's pretty cool. Do you guys have any plans? Yeah? I think my wife and I, we are going to Houston. We're going to see some family this weekend. Carolyn, what are you doing? Carolyn is hanging out with her family too. Very cool. Very cool. Hopefully you guys can make some memories this weekend, and hopefully outside. Hopefully the weather's nice for you guys. Okay. You guys ready? Let's talk about the station. Okay, here it is. So this is our brand new station. And what that means is it's not just a log rack. Okay. It's way, way more than that. It's a fire pit storage station. Okay. That sounds like kind of like fancy lingo. I know it sounds fancy, but there's a lot that this thing can do that no other log rack, no other wood storage system on the market can do. And we're excited to show you off. So thank you guys for being here. As you can see here, though, we've got a ton of firewood bundled up. So we want to do something fun right off the top. So now that you guys have tagged a friend, to enter to win the station, we're going to do something different, like right here off the top at the beginning of the stream. We want you guys in the comments right now to guess how many pieces of firewood are stacked up right here. And these are the pieces of firewood that we already had in the station. We took out so you guys could see this. How many pieces of solo stove juniper firewood, cut to about 10 inches like this, are here? That's the only hint I'm gonna give you, is that it's our firewood. So put that in there. The first person to get it right, we'll announce in just a second. So while you guys are putting those numbers in, let's go ahead and play a video. So we made this video in just like 30 seconds to show you guys what this station can do. And then I'll do a longer demo and we'll talk about it. We'll answer you guys' questions too. So with that being said, play that video. What'd you think? That was a pretty cool video, right? We tried to cram as much cool stuff in there as possible. Major props to Matt, who's pushing the buttons behind the camera today. He shot all that. That was his idea to do that cool little like tracking side to side shot that shows off one of the coolest features of the station, that it holds all of our fire pits, which is pretty cool. So Carolyn, do we have a winner for the amount of firewood? And I didn't actually say what you guys are winning. You're winning a solo stove campfire. Well, that's pretty cool. So the winner of the amount of wood, we have a name? Okay. The winner is Brian Cavatahe of the first giveaway we're doing. Brian Cavatahe got it right. There are 70 pieces of wood here. So let's get him in the station. And while we do that, we'll answer some questions. So congratulations, Brian. He is our first winner. But guys, if you didn't win just now, that's okay. Tag a friend. and we'll do some station stuff.
Oh, did I disconnect? Okay, hold on. Okay, there we go. Okay, all right, so let's open up the station. We're gonna open up the cover. It's got little Velcro pieces on the bottom which holds it together. And I just had to walk around that way because the firewood stacked up here. And then what you do to reveal the inside here, oh, what's this? There's a sparkling water, which is good. It's really hot today. I don't know who put that there. That was very nice of them. What you want to do is just roll it up. So it's going to take me just a second here. And you just kind of roll it up here. So you can actually see, which was maybe hidden by the firewood, there's an awesome solo stove logo on the bottom there. So you can see that. You just roll it up like this. Try to keep it straight. The firewood is blocking my where I would usually stand. And then it's got two pieces on the bottom. One right here. A little plastic peg that fits through this loop, just like that. And then one more here. And that holds each piece, each flap of the cover. It holds it up, just like that. So if you want to leave your station open like this, you can do that. And it's going to be securely kind of held in there, just like so. So let's stack the wood in here so you guys can see. And while we do that, we have like our top five questions that we actually launched this yesterday. We launched this yesterday, and you guys have asked a bunch of questions to our customer service team. So while we do that, while we stack the wood in here, we'll answer some questions from you guys. So question number one, what do we got? What are the dimensions of the station? Okay, I have a tape measure here, but, okay, so what's the height? 52, okay, so the height of the station is 52.5 inches tall. Are we on fancy cam? Okay, hey guys. We have a separate camera just for this, what we plan to be the most exciting segment that you will ever see. Someone just loading firewood into a fire pit or firewood storage thing here. But it's actually awesome to see. And what I didn't say when I said that there were 70 pieces of firewood here is that this is the amount of wood that will actually fit on one shelf. So you can take that and you can double it if you want and put a bunch of firewood on the top as well. But what I like to do is put my firewood on the bottom and then my fire pit on the top. And we'll talk about that in just a second. Okay, another question. Yeah, yeah, Carolyn, that is a good point. So the firewood that we have here, I already mentioned, this is solo stove firewood. So we'll ship this to your house. This is our juniper firewood. It's cut to about 10 inches long. Look at this, I have a tape measure. It's cut, this one is exactly, whoa, it's exactly 10 inches long. So this will actually double stack. If you get your firewood ordered from somewhere, if you don't order from us, get it cut to about 10 inches because that way you can double stack your firewood in here. So you can kind of see what I'm doing. You can stack your firewood in two rows. This is actually, so this is 70 pieces, like I said, per shelf, or at least that's what we've done here. But that's 10 of our bundles. So 10 firewood bundles per shelf is about what we're saying fits. Okay, we have another question. What is the material of the station cover? That's a great question. The cover is actually made of, I can show you here, it's PVC on the inside, so it's weather resistant, and then fabric on the outside, also weather resistant. And the cool thing about this fabric, we have two colors. So you can get, this is the premium ash gray color. I think it looks awesome. I think it looks very, very cool. Has very, like a nice contrast to the metal frame of the station. But they both, that this one and the black one, we have two colors, so this is the premium, black is the other color. They both provide the same functionality, so it's like a fabric exterior. But what I like about both is that they are really well suited to being outside. So when you're outside, you things get dirty, right? Like it rains and all sorts of stuff happens, they might get some smudges on them. They hold up really, really well, the cover does, to any kind of smudging. And just another feature about the cover
It's actually open on the side, so like right here, and that is on purpose. So we planned it to be open a little bit so it can breathe. So if you want to take your firewood and season it, which means you can like leave it out longer than, if it needs to dry, you can leave it out. It will season in here, which is great. Or if you just don't want it to get moldy, you want your firewood to have some breathability in its storage as well. So the cover, we're almost done with this segment here. Do you see how much wood this thing holds? I didn't know how long this would take on camera, so hopefully this is not the most mind-numbingly boring thing any of you guys have ever seen. But I think it's a cool demonstration of how much wood the station actually holds, because it's a lot. Let me just do... Okay, no, go ahead, Carolyn. Woo! Guys, we did it. We did it. Okay, and Brandon asks a great question. How many bundles of wood would you need per shelf? Is that what he asked, Carolyn? Okay, so Brandon asked how many bundles per shelf. This is 10 bundles of our firewood right here. About 70 pieces. So we counted, we're exactly 70 pieces. And there's still some room in here. Like you could stack some more if you wanted to. This is kind of what we're recommending as the amount that it can hold per shelf. So 70 pieces, 10 bundles times two if you want. But in just a second, we're gonna show off the fire pits and how they fit in here too. So as we are right now, do we have any questions? Any additional questions? Okay. Yeah, okay, so Mary wants to know, will the wood get wet? Which this we might have a good demonstration here because it's starting to sprinkle a little bit. So we'll prove this in real time, but just fingers crossed it doesn't rain too hard on all our equipment. So the rain will shed off on all sides. You might get like a little sprinkling here on the sides, but we've tested it. It keeps the firewood as dry as it needs to be burned in a solo stove. It's gonna be covered, it's gonna be safe. And it lets it breathe. So that's the most, I know I've got this kind of rolled up here, but if this were rolled down, there is some breathability here, and that is on purpose. So you want your firewood to not be stagnant. You don't want moisture, humidity to kind of get stuck in there. That's why we designed it this way. And the other additional benefit is that each side can kind of roll up independently if you want to. There's another feature which we're going to talk about as soon as we're done with the fire pits, and that's the accessory tool holder. So just wait. There's like, this is the most exciting demonstration of a log rack that you've ever seen. But that's a good point too. I wanna talk about this for a second. This is not really just a log rack. Like you can go and get a cheap log rack anywhere. Like we know those exist. But what we wanted to do is we wanted to create something that was actually, it was more outdoor furniture than it is a log rack. So what that means is we know our fire pits because they can be burned on a wood deck with a stand, that you guys are putting these fire pits in places that are attractive, that you're excited about, that are, you know, outdoor extensions of your home. And what Station does really well with the way it's designed, how cool it looks, is it's been designed to work alongside high class furniture. So this is really a piece of furniture. I know that sounds kind of weird to think about, but that's what was in our heads while we were creating it. So not only is it great for wood storage, it's great for fire pit storage, accessories, tools, but it looks great alongside all of your other stuff, your outdoor furniture, whether you've got like a patio set, whatever it is, you're excited about it and you spend a lot of time and possibly a lot of money. You don't want to put something cheap next to all that. And this is definitely not that. So it's not just a log rack, it's more outdoor furniture, but it's just a solo stove storage solution. Okay, Carolyn, I'm gonna pull some fire pits in here. Let's talk about those, okay? Okay, so, yeah, hit me. The bumpers. Okay, people have asked about the bumpers. Okay, so this is a good thing. Before I get into the fire pit themselves, this is a good segue. So these are our bumpers, and they take a little bit of beating because the bottom of the fire pits are sharp. So we wanted to put something in here so that as you're taking your fire pit in and out, that it actually absorbs some of the impact from your fire pit and you're not damaging your station as you're putting it in here, in and out repeatedly for a long time. We want this to last for a long, long, long time for you guys. So these are our bumpers. There's two of them that come with the station. That one's kind of wedged in there a little bit. Yeah, which is good because once you get them placed, you don't really want them to go anywhere. So you get two, and you can put them wherever you want. You can put them here in the middle, which I would recommend for the Bonfire or the Yukon. Or if you want to do the Ranger, put the Ranger on the side, you can put the bumpers right here and then put accessories here and put your Ranger here. So we'll go through that in just a second. But these are the fire pit bumpers. So I want to do the Yukon first because we're getting the most questions about the Yukon, which is understandable because the Yukons are big, right? And our previous station was not designed to hold the Yukon. So when we went back to the drawing board, we wanted to make sure this worked for all of our fire pits. So that being said, let's bring in the Yukon so you guys can see that. One hand. Look at that. Okay, maybe two hands. Maybe two hands. The Yukon's big. Okay, so there's the Yukon. This is the Yukon 27. I didn't bring a Yukon 30 out here just for time. I want to get through everything quickly. So this is the Yukon 27. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put it in the top. I would recommend using a handle with this. So this is one of our other accessories. I'll just show it off real quick. This is the fire pit handle. If you haven't seen it, you can get it on solostove.com. Not very expensive. Pops inside the fire pit just like this. And if you have a stand, you would want to nest your stand inside the fire pit as well. And then you can take it and just pop it in just like that. So the Yukon 27, I can go back just a little bit more. It does stick off the edge just a little bit, which is honestly fine. When you put the cover down, the cover extends over it and you can't even tell. The Yukon 30 does stick out a little bit more. So it's got a little bit more of a bump to it, but it does fit in here just fine. You can see you've got some extra space here on both sides of the 27. So there you go. If you guys own a Yukon 27, a Yukon, our previous model, the Yukon 30, it's our legacy model. If you have one of those, it will fit in here as well. So this is it. This is, if you own the Yukon, your Yukon would fit right here, and then 70 pieces of firewood could fit at the bottom. Okay, so there's Yukon. I'll take it out and we'll do Bonfire. And again, like I said, if you have the stand, it would be nested inside your fire pit first. Okay, next, here's our friend Bonfire. So you guys can also see him side by side. If you haven't ordered one of these yet, you can see how much bigger the Bonfire or the Yukon is than the Bonfire. So here's like a little demo of that. So the Bonfire would then just slide in just like that. And see why I'm saying the handle works really, really well. You don't have to get your hands on the side of the fire pit and keep your fingerprints off it. So I would recommend, if you don't have the handle yet and you're buying the station, toss it in the cart and get that too, because it works perfectly for this. You can just take it in and out just like that, which is great. And you can also see here that the bumpers are raising the surface of the shelf up a little bit so that the sharp edge of the, it's not too sharp, but the sharper edge of each fire pit is kind of raised above the surface, so it's protecting everything. Okay, last but not least, so our friend the Ranger. So for the Ranger, I'm gonna take the bumpers, these guys right here, I'm gonna put them on the right side here. So one in the middle, one on the right. And then the Ranger, am I breathing heavily right now? Woo, we are doing some work today. And it's starting to sprinkle a little bit too. You can probably see that on the fire pits. But that's gonna show off how weather resistant the shelter is. The cover is on the station. So there you go. There's the Ranger inside there, which is great, the Ranger, because you can take your sticks. You can put those here. You can put some, bags of starters, hatchet, whatever kind of additional accessories you have. We have our support crew just came in. I wish you guys could see. They're very stealthily placing a canopy above our cameras because it is starting to rain a little bit. But we planned this, so we wanted to show how water resistant the shelter is. So, thank you. So there you guys can see. So there's all three fire pits that we sell currently fitting in here. I've tested the Yukon 30. It does fit as well. And then you can kind of see how it works. So if you guys are just joining us, this is our new product, the Solar Stove Station, which we're excited to show off today. If you haven't done this yet, if you just joined us a couple minutes ago, tag a friend in the comments. That will enter you to win a station, which is pretty exciting. It's pretty exciting. We already gave away a campfire earlier. Somebody guessed that there were 70 pieces of wood right there, double stacked, which is pretty cool. So with that being said, let's do some questions, and then I'll do our last feature on the station. What do you got for me, Carolyn? Can you place items on top of the station? Okay, that's a good question. Lightweight items you can place on top of there. It's gonna be fine, but it was not designed to hold weight. So this is a plastic piece right here that's designed not to add too much weight to the top of the station, but it's designed to perfectly hold the cover. So the cover can kind of pop off here if you need it to. And it just holds the cover, and it's designed to hold maybe like 5-10 pounds. You're not supposed to put things on top of this right here. A little bit of snow is okay, but if you get like 10 inches of snow, you'll want to kind of brush that off the top after a while, because it's not designed to hold weight. You don't want to put firewood on there. You definitely don't want to put your fire pit on there. But that's a great question. What else? If you guys do have any more questions, feel free to put those in the comments. We're going to try to get to as many questions as we can today. Okay, we had another question. What is it made out of? Okay, that's a good question. So we've talked about the cover on top of the station, but the station itself is made out of powder-covered aluminum, which means it's not that heavy. Do you know the weight off the top of your head? 47 pounds. Okay, ooh, Ty beat you, Carolyn. He gave me some fingers. So the station weighs 47 pounds without anything in it. So it's, you know, it's sturdy. Like, it's not going to go anywhere. Wind's not going to move this thing around. But when you unload it, you can move it around to a different place on your patio if you want to. But it is designed to be used when it's loaded stationary. You know, we didn't put wheels on this thing because we don't want anything tipping over for you guys. It's a stationary item. Awesome. No, so it doesn't move around. It's very sturdy. It has like a little play to it, but it's super sturdy. It can hold 250 pounds, bottom and top shelf. And speaking of the shelves, I have my tape measure here. One of you guys asked customer service, or a couple of you asked customer service yesterday, what the height of each shelf is. And it's about 20 and a half from the top of the bottom shelf to the bottom of the top shelf. And then you've got, you know, inside here, you've got another 20 inches or so. So plenty of space there. I think we showed off the measurements earlier, but it's 54 inches tall. It is 35 inches wide, and then like 24 inches deep. Okay, let's do the accessory rack, Carolyn. Huh? Okay, I'm gonna come over here to this other side. I know I'm bouncing around a lot, but there's a lot to go over with this thing. So I'm gonna roll this side up here so you guys can see in here. I'll try to do this really fast. Been working on my rolling skills, as one does. Voila. Okay, so now that I've got this panel rolled up, let's talk about the storage of the accessories, which we call the tool rack. So which camera am I looking at? Fancy cam. Hey guys. Okay, so over here you've got five kind of drop points for tools. So right now I've got the fire pit tools in here, both the log grabber and the firewood poker. They fit like perfectly here on the side, just like so. And then I also have the shield removal tools. They would fit here as well. And I meant to grab the sticks, but I actually grabbed the grill tools. They're in the same, very similar bag. But you could take all of your Solar Stove sticks and you could place them assembled instead of in the bag. You could place them 1, 2, 3, 4 right there, and then they're ready to go. So it just depends on how you want to use them. But again, the sticks have a carry bag like this, so you could also just keep them in there and keep them inside the station. So up to you guys. So this is the tool holder, which fits all of your firewood accessories or your fire pit accessories, which is pretty cool. So let's get these out of the way so you guys can see the station in its entirety. We have a great question. Okay, go for it. That is a great question. And Carolyn, I'm going to answer that question in my chair. We have been running around like crazy today. Okay, give me that question one more time. That is a great question. Ashley has a great question. She wants to know, how long should she wait until the fire has died down before she can put her fire pit inside here? And it depends on the fire pit that you're using, but I would say at least 2 hours, but really more like 3 to 6 hours. Your fire pit needs to be completely cool before you're putting it in here. You don't want to put a fire pit in here that has anything burning or warm inside it, any kind of embers. Nope, just keep it out of the fire of the station. And then when it's completely cool, when you can pick it up with your hands, there's no embers inside, then you can pop it in here. And you know, that's a good point as well. You could use this, like I've kind of mentioned a couple times, for wood as well. If you want to just put wood up here, if you have a fire pit shelter and you keep your fire pit outside all the time with the shelter on, you can do that as well and then load this thing up with wood, or you can use your lid or any of the other accessories that we have with the fire pits. But that's a great question. Completely cool, then you can put it inside the station. Okay, what else? Hit me. This is my question answering chair, which is very comfortable. Does the new cover fit the old station? Okay, it does not. And that's a really good question too. So we sold another station a couple years ago that was, it's kind of a legacy product. This is, again, back to the drawing board. It came up with something completely different that is, we thought about everything. All of the accessories that we've came out with in the last really like year and a half, like this was designed for that. Like the current solo stove, power user, pro user, whatever you want to call yourself. So this cover right here does not fit the previous station. They're different. But again, completely different. This is, you know, designed from the ground up to be something like different for you. More functional for sure than the old station. What else you got? You guys are asking great questions. So I'm going to say this one more time. And then we'll that'll be your last reminder. So tag a friend right now. This is your last chance. And then we are going to give one of these stations away. Are we still on Fancy Cam? Yeah. Hi, Fancy Cam. We call, if you're new to the stream, we only, for the longest time, we only had one camera. And then when we got a second camera, it was like a top-down shot to show off how cool the fire pit burns. But we affectionately call that Fancy Cam, which keeps us humble, I think, around here. So I'm talking to Fancy Cam right now. I just wanted to give a little live stream history. That should have been a trivia question to see if anybody knew. Okay, any more questions? This is a great question. Yes. Yes. Okay, I'm going to get up. I'm going to get back up for this one. So do you know who asked that question? Because it's a great question. Okay, a lot of you guys have asked this question, Carolyn says. So the question is, does the tool holder, like, is it on both sides? So no, it's not on this side. There's nothing over here. But that brings up a good point. If you want to put this in the corner, if you've got a nice corner of your patio or wherever, it would work because it is the same on this side as it is the other side. So while the tool holder, you see it right now, like over here on this side, you could like flip this and then have it go the other way. So then the other side becomes the front. I think I said that in a way that makes sense. But basically it's reversible. So you can have the accessory, the tool rack on any side that is most convenient for you. So that's a great question. I'm glad somebody asked that because I forgot. Cool. What else? Brian is asking, do I feel empty without a fire going today? And that's kind of a good question because, like, we've talked about this before. When we have a fire going in a live stream, it just crackles and it has this, like, nice, heartwarming sound that just kind of fills any awkward pauses when I can't think of what to say. And I do feel a little bit sad when we do a live stream that doesn't have a fire pit going, because I just love hanging around our fire pits and our grills and our camping stoves. But when there's something that we really need to focus on, we do it. We do it because we want you guys to have all the info you need about all of our products. But that's a good question. What else? Is the middle shelf adjustable? Great question. Okay, so this middle shelf, the product, when it ships to your house, this side, that side, they're welded, like they're pieces that are ready to go. These shelves are, they will need to be screwed in. There's not that many screws. It really doesn't take that long to put together. But these are the only points for these shelves. You have to put this middle shelf in, like it, that needs that for structural integrity. But this is the only place that it can go. So you can't raise or lower this shelf. But trust us, we did a lot of research and testing of all of our fire pits and how you guys would use wood. And this works really well. So I've used this as much as many people outside of product dev who actually designed this product. And we've taken it on photo shoots and all sorts of stuff. Like this works really well. Holds a ton of wood. It holds a ton of wood. When we went to do that video shoot for the video you guys saw earlier, it takes a lot of lugging stuff around to get the firewood out for this shoot. And it just holds a ton of wood. So anyway, that's a long way of saying it. It holds as much wood in the best configuration as possible. So it's not a big deal, but that is a great question. Cool, what else we got? Another great question. Do you need the lid? Do you need the shelter or the shield or anything to use this? You don't necessarily need it. I'll take the Ranger out here, and then we've got a Ranger lid. I'll grab that. Ranger shelter is, or Ranger shield is somewhere else, but that's the Ranger lid. So all of the fire pit accessories that nest inside the fire pit, you would want to nest them and then put them in here. Or your shelter, or your shield could go on the side if you've got a Ranger or a Bonfire, because you've got some additional space on the side. So up to you guys. But if it were me and I was done at the end of the night, ready to store my fire pit, or put it up for the winter or whatever you're doing, this is your storage solution, I would nest everything inside your fire pit and then place it in here. So I think the handle is kind of covering the lid, but you can place your lid on the Ranger and then pop this in there just like that. So that's a great question. So many good questions. Oh, yeah. Okay, that's a good question. I keep saying that, but these are honestly good questions. I think, and maybe not even all of these were in our FAQ, so you guys are helping us out. Are there protective feet on the bottom of the station? And there are. So there is aluminum that goes all the way down to the bottom, and then there are little bumper feet, like plastic bumper feet that have little grippies on them. They've just got little dashes in them. But you can see that right down here. There's one right there. And they've got some traction to them too. So you've got, you know, nice solid contact points for where the station comes into contact with your deck or wherever you're putting it. I mean, we're putting it on these like paver stones here. So we just had to kind of maneuver it to get it to a flat point. But if you're on your deck, you know, boom, just pop it there, and it's not going anywhere, I promise. Like, once you got this loaded down with wood, it's not going anywhere. Great question. What else do we got, Carolyn? Oh, you're laughing. Is it funny? We have a funny question? Oh, you're laughing to fill time as you search for a question. What collar does the cover come in? Great question. There are two options. So this option that we have here, let's go ahead and put this down. We've had it open for long enough so you guys can kind of see it that way if you're just joining us. There we go. You just roll it down like so. Look at that. So this is the premium ash gray collar. That's what we're calling it. So if you go on the website, you get two collar options. This is the premium version. It's a little bit more expensive just because it's the premium collar, and it looks super cool. And then there is also the default option. If you don't make any selection at all, it's default on black, which looks great as well. The only difference is really that the logo on the black one is in white, and here it's in black. So you can see it on the site. So if you go to solostove.com/station, that will take you directly there, or just go to solostove.com as well. So let's take this time to kind of talk about pricing too. So if you guys, now that we've talked a lot about the station, if it sounds interesting to you guys, I hope it does, because it's a really, really cool product and we're excited about it. We worked really hard on it. This is kind of like an introductory price. So we just want to give you guys a heads up. This is an intro price. I've been told this is as cheap as it's ever going to go. So, you know, if you're looking at it and you want to snag one, we're selling them pretty fast. So we've got, you know, like an initial order. You want to get yours in first, and now is the time to do that. I'm not going to push you too hard on it, but now is the lowest price, or like now is when you can get the lowest price that it will kind of ever be. So you guys are seeing it first, and we're giving you that opportunity to get it and buy it first. So there you go. Now you get that information. But if you guys have any additional questions that we didn't answer on the stream, our customer service reps are awesome. They can take care of you as you're shopping. If you're making a decision over the weekend on this thing, you've got time, and we'll take care of you. So now that this is down, you can see these straps here, little Velcro straps. They actually go on the inside of the legs, just like that. And that keeps it, you know, that keeps everything lined up. That keeps the cover from moving around too much. It's kind of fun when you roll it down. And then I'll do the one on the back here. Cool. I mean, as you can see, like it takes no time. If you just need to do that really fast, you can unhook these and then just pull it up and grab what you need out of there and drop it down. Totally up to you. But that's how you would keep each independent flap hoisted up there. If that's the right word. Cool. I'm FaceTiming you? Uh-oh. I'm butt dialing Carolyn right now. Ignore it. Okay. Awesome. Well, I think we're getting pretty darn close to the end here. So let's do one more question, and then we will do something. We'll give a product away. Let me see. Hey, Carolyn. How are you? I hung up on Carolyn. Okay, let's do one more question, and then we'll get out of here. We'll give a station away, and we'll see you guys next week. Okay, what do you got? The rolly strap things. Do they mean when you roll each flap up and kind of connect it right here? Okay. No, that's okay. They're little plastic pins that go in here, and then they just kind of hook it into place. So not Velcro on the top, Velcro down here to hold the independent flaps together at the bottom, and then little plastic pieces that kind of hold it in once you've rolled it up. So, whoo, we answered a lot of questions today. So hopefully we got to yours. If we didn't, again, customer service will take care of you guys. And it's been fun. Hopefully this was as informative as we could make it. And I think we got to pretty much everything we could talk about with the station. All the info is on the website. Go to solostove.com and check that out. But I've talked enough. Let's do some giving away. And then we hope you guys have a great weekend. So I'm going to get my drumroll hands warmed up here while Carolyn finds a winner of the people that tagged a friend. And then we'll do it. So if you're at home and you're watching, let's all do a drumroll together. Here we go. The winner of the Solo Stove Station is Brandon Huey. Huey, right? Yeah. Brandon, congrats. That's awesome. Thank you so much for watching. Brandon, everybody in the comments say congrats, Brandon. And thank you to everybody that helped us set all this stuff up. There were a lot of people around here today. Thank you to our product development team for making such awesome products. And that's really all we got. So we hope that you guys have an awesome weekend. Thanks for hanging out. We will be back next Wednesday on Instagram. So if you're not following us on Instagram, go do that. We're live on there almost every Wednesday with cooking recipes where we meet up with the chef. So we're going to be live on Wednesday, and then next Friday we'll be right back here hanging out on Facebook and YouTube. If you're watching us on YouTube, hey, we'll be back then. So everybody, have a good weekend, and we will see you next week. Have a happy Memorial Day.